What's up, guys? Thank you for joining. Today, I'm gonna teach you how to create a toggle button in Power BI. And I'm gonna do this step by step as always. But before we get started, if this is the first time you stop by this channel, please don't forget to subscribe if you don't wanna miss anything. So now, let's do this. This is the Power BI report that we're going to be using for this tutorial. Before we get started with the case, with the example, let me quickly talk about toggle buttons in Power BI. A toggle button is actually a type of visual that allows users to switch between different views or models in a report by clicking a button. Toggle buttons can be useful for allowing users to easily explore and analyze data in a Power BI report by switching different views or filters. There are a couple of advantages if we use toggle buttons in Power BI. So the first one is that you can save space on the canvas, and you will see here in the example. And the second reason is that you can empower your end users because they will be able to play with that button and then analyze data based on those results. So now let's stop talking and let's do this. So the first step here is to create a couple of bookmarks. So let's go over view and then select bookmarks. So once we are here, let's add our first bookmark. We're gonna rename this bookmark as toggle on. So we're gonna create another bookmark and we're gonna rename this as toggle off. So the next step here is to insert a bookmark navigator. So let's do that. Let's hit insert, let's go over here, buttons, and then navigator. Once we are here, let's select bookmark navigator. Check this out. So once you do that, because we already created our first two bookmarks, it automatically gets populated here. So let's keep this as is for now. So the next step here is to create a group. So let me show you how it works. So let's go over here again. Toggle on, let's select toggle on, right click, and then group. So once we are done here, if you expand this, you will see that toggle on is under group one. So we can rename this as well. So let's say that we wanna call this just toggle, we can do that. It's up to you. And now we are done with this step. So the next step here is to configure and format the toggle. So let's do this. And this is the critical step, so please pay close attention. So let's select this visual. And then once we are done with this, let's go over here, click this option. And as you can see, bookmarks is here. Let's expand this. And here, let's select toggle. This is the group that we just created. And then let's turn this feature on. This is the allow deselection option, okay? So let's do that. Once we are done with this, now let's select here, toggle off. Perfect. As you can see, this changed automatically here. We are just seeing here one visual. Let's keep moving. So let's select the visual again, and let's click on the bookmarks option here. And here we're gonna change the name of the bookmark, okay? And this is really cool, my friend, because we're gonna use the Windows emoji keyboard. So hold down the Windows key and then press semicolon. So once you do that, you have these options here. You have many options here, but for this particular case, we're gonna select here the first one, which is the black circle. So let's do that. Let's see what happens. Let's close this. Boom, let's hit enter. So now you can see here the black circle. So we're gonna be making a couple of adjustments here, so don't worry. So let's keep formatting this toggle, my friends. So let's go over here and then let's get started with the toggle off option or the toggle off bookmark. So let's select this and then let's select format And once we are here, let's go over shape. So this should be rectangle. So we are good there. And then how about the rounded corners? How about 20 here for now? And then as you can see, this is changing, right? So that's the idea. So now let's move on to the next feature here, style. Once we are here, toggle off is gonna be the default version, okay? So we are good here. And then the alignment here for the font, in other words, for the black circle, should be left. Now you can see this is changing, right? And then here, how about if we select 10, the padding, 10 pixels, perfect. And then for fill, this is the background. How about light gray here? So we are good. And then for border, let's turn this off for now. And I think we are good to go. Perfect. There it is. So now let's go back to bookmarks again. And let's do this for the toggle on feature or the toggle on bookmark. Let's select the bookmark here and let's do the same. Let's go with shape. This should be rectangle, 20 pixels, that's fine. Let's go over style here. So once we are here, and this should be selected, okay? This is critical, my friends. And then for text, let's leave this as is for now. And then for alignment, that should be on the right side. And then this should be 0 for padding here on the left side, but should be 10 pixels on the right side. And then for fill, so let's look for something for this color here. And then border is off, so we are good there. And I think we are good to go. So guys, we are almost done. You can keep customizing this if you want. Just keep making adjustments here and then you will be good to go. Perfect. So now guys, let's test this. Hold down control, click right there. There you go. Hold down control, there you go. So it's working. As you can see, we didn't import any visuals here, any images. We are just using the native Power BI buttons. So this is perfect. So now guys, this is the time to apply this toggle button to this Power BI report. As you can see, we have two different visuals here on the right side. We have this area chart and we also have this table. This is the KPIs table. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna overlap these two visuals. Let's do this real quick. Boom. We are overlapping here these two visuals. And now you have this free space where you can add perhaps a comment or maybe other visuals. So let's add some text here and I'm gonna show you how to do this real quick. Let's go by insert here and then text box. And here let's type profits. Let's make a couple of adjustments here as well. It's right there. Perhaps 14 here. And here we're gonna duplicate this, Control C, Control V. And then here we're gonna add KPIs. There you go. The next step here is go over view again and let's hit selection. And now as you can see, every single visual is actually here and you can hide them. You can do whatever you want here. So for this particular case, let's select profit here and then let's rename. This is profits. And then the other one, this should be profits KPIs or just profit KPIs. Okay. So let's do this real quick. Let's rename this. It should be profit KPIs. So what is the main goal with this? Is that we can hide or we can make this visible and it's easy to recognize them. Okay. So let's drag this over here. Perhaps this should be actually 12, so we have more space. And then this one right here should also be 12. And then we have profits there, and then let's drag this over here as well and overlap them. So once we have done this, now we are ready to play with this toggle. Let's go over bookmarks here. We have two different bookmarks here, remember that. And also let's hit selection. And this is the time, my friends. If we go back to bookmarks here, let's select toggle off for now. As you can see, for toggle off, we want to hide the table. So that's what we're doing here. And then for the text, we need to hide profit KPIs because this is just profits, okay? This is quite straightforward. And once we are done with this, let's go back to bookmarks here and then right click, update. Boom. So now let's do the same for toggle on. Let's go over here. This is toggle on. And then let's hit selection again. And here we need to hide the profits by year month. Table should be visible, so we are good. But let's hide this for now and let's make this visible again. It's working perfectly fine. And then for text, this should be profit KPIs. So this should be visible, and then profits, this should be hidden. Perfect. So now we are talking, my friends. So let's go back to bookmarks here again. And once we are here, right click, update. Boom. So now this should be working perfectly fine. So let's test this. Hold down control and click right there. Boom. So now it's taking you just to profits. That's the default, the toggle off. And we have profits here. So now let's click on the toggle button again and let's see what happens. Hold down control. Boom. So now this is taking you to the table results, the KPI, and the text also changed, as you can see. So there you have it, my friends. Really, really powerful. Like I said before, you don't have to insert any type of images or visuals. You are just using here the native buttons that we have in Power BI Desktop. So there you have it, my friends. Toggle buttons in Power BI are really powerful. I hope you found this content helpful. If so, as always, please give me a thumbs up, share with your friends, and of course, don't forget to subscribe if you don't want to miss anything. Thank you guys, and see you next time.